Welcome back to Spark Physics by Ashish sir. The next topic which we will be doing today is capacitance of parallel plate capacitor. We have discussed in the previous video what is capacitor, how it is charged now and what is its formula and how it can be increased or decreased, and in the previous video also I have discussed you how it is changed, how we can change the capacity of the capacitance. Now you see capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor. We have taken two parallel plates. One is positively charged, another is negatively charged. Separation between them is small d. Here we have plus Q charge, this is minus Q charge. So what is parallel plate capacitor now? You can see a parallel plate capacitor consists of two large plane parallel conducting plates separated by a small distance. Okay, here they are separated by small distance, we are writing because it has got meaning which I will tell you in the next lines. Here you can see it is saying the parallel plate capacitor is nothing but it is the device which consists of two parallel plates, right? Large parallel plates. Okay, if we take area of the plates A, separation between the plate is D. Sigma, if we take uniform surface charge density, we have defined earlier that sigma surface charge density is nothing but charge per unit area. Now, here you see, what about the electric field? In the previous video, we have seen while solving the numericals of chapter 1, there was one question that two plates, parallel plates are there and you need to find out what is the electric field on the left side of the left plate, right side of the right plate and in between the plates. Similar, same concept is applied here. We can see here, this in the region above the plates, electric field is 0. Below the lower plate, electric field is 0. But here, in between the plates, we see that the electric field due to this, it is in the downward direction. Or when we take the positive charge, the field lines are in outward direction, field is in outward direction. So the field is coming in this direction, but when it comes to negative, then electric field goes towards the negative charge. So again it will be going towards the negative charge. So electric field due to this, electric field due to this plate, both will get added up. So we get sigma upon epsilon naught in between the plates. So same thing I have written in the outer region, above the upper plate and below the lower plate, electric field is 0 because due to these two charge plates, the electric field gets cancelled. ठीक है? तो जो electric field है वो ऊपर और नीचे दोनों plate के cancel हो जाता है और बीच में electric field add हो जाता है और हमको मिलता है sigma upon epsilon. In the inner region, we are getting sigma upon epsilon. एक बड़ा अच्छा सा concept है, आप देखिए, one mark में कभी-कभी पूछ लेते हैं. For the plates with the finite area, ये जो plates का area हम fix ले रहे हैं, the field lines bend at the edges. ये जो edge है, यहाँ से field line bend हो जाती है. तो उनको हम बोलते हैं, this effect is called fringing of the field. Fringing of the field, जो field lines या फील्ड जो एजेस से बेंड होगा उसको हम बोलते हैं फ्रिंजिंग ऑफ द फील्ड, याद रखेंगे. बट वी ऑलवेज कंसीडर लार्ज प्लेट्स, फॉर लार्ज प्लेट सेपरेटेड बाय स्मॉल डिस्टेंस. तो ये जो फ्रिंजिंग इफेक्ट है हम इसको लेकर नहीं चलते हैं. ऐसे आपने फर्स्ट चैप्टर में देखा है गॉसेस लॉस में, हमने क्या बताया था आपको कि जो फर्स्ट एप्लीकेशन है, वी टेक लॉन्ग वायर, इनफाइनाइटली लॉन्ग वायर, सो नेग्लेक्ट दीज इफेक्ट्स. Infinitely long sheet, second application of Gauss law, है ना? तो वैसे ही यहाँ पर हम large plates ले रहे हैं, separated by small distance. तो जब field uniform होता है large plates में, जब separated by small distance यदि हम ले रहे हैं, तो field वहाँ हम uniform consider करते हैं. और हमको मालूम है, for uniform field, what is potential? We have derived relation E is equal to minus dV by dr. So we can write V is the potential difference between the plates, electric field is E and distance is d. So we can write V is equal to, now value of E you can see here, we have got sigma upon epsilon naught. So we have put the value E is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught into D. Okay. Now you see, what is the capacitance formula? It is Q upon V. We will substitute Q is equal to sigma A. Okay. And we have got sigma D upon epsilon naught. So we are getting C is equal to epsilon naught A upon D. Now you can see the capacitance, it depends on number one, epsilon naught, that is medium between the plates. Number two, it depends on area of the plates. And number three, it depends on separation. How it depends? It is directly proportional to medium, it is directly proportional to area of the plates, and it is inversely proportional to separation between the plates. मतलब यदि आप सेपरेशन कम करेंगे तो कैपेसिटेंस बढ़ जाएगा, सेपरेशन ज्यादा कर देंगे कैपेसिटेंस कम हो जाएगा. ओके स्टूडेंट, नाउ वी हैव फिनिश्ड दिस, द कैपेसिटेंस ऑफ पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर. इसके आगे का वीडियो नेक्स्ट वीडियो में हम समझेंगे कि नेक्स्ट टॉपिक क्या है. पैरेलल प्लेट से ही हम आगे आएंगे कि अब इस कैपेसिटेंस को कैसे बढ़ा सकते हैं. दैट विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. थैंक यू.